Hello dears, next topic we are going to study here is Sjögren syndrome. Sjögren syndrome. I'm sure you heard about this. The pathophysiology behind here, it is a lymphoplasmocytic infiltration of exocrine glands, mainly like parotid and all. So normally you will have dry mouth, we call it as xerostomia. As a result, the patient will have dental caries and you will have parotid swelling. So you do a biopsy to confirm it, you will see antibody. Then they will have dry eye, we call it as keratoconjunctivitis sicca. They will have dry vagina, as a result like a painful dyspareunia, painful sexual intercourse, perineunia, painful sexual intercourse. Now it's not a typical feature, arthritis can be seen, dry, everything will be dry here. So listen, exactly saying this all happening because there is an antibody, this is the reason for this. The best diagnosing you can find this RoLA. If you are from India, you know RO means don't, RO cry, LA means do, Arabic LA, RoLA for Sjögren syndrome, remember like that. This antibody in pregnant woman, they crosses the placenta and they can cause even fetal heart block, that much dangerous this is. Actually for diagnosing, right, they are ANA positive, anti-nuclear antibody positive, and rheumatoid factor will be also positive, but they are not specific. As I told you, you check for RoLA, that is the main thing, the best diagnostic one, this will be the correct answer they ask you. And you can do even biopsy of what, parotid and all, to check it. Then for tears, dry eye, we can do a test called Skirmer test. If you activate your tear gland, you must have more tear from your eye. If that is coming, or if that is not coming, or something not enough is not produced, so you can surely confirm this is Sjögren syndrome. The Skirmer test will be done for them. Now treatment, sure we give what, artificial tears, saliva or lubricants, that is the only thing we can do here. That is for what, Sjögren syndrome. Along with that, there is something called idiopathic inflammatory myositis. It is also autoimmune. You can see antibodies here. Actually this is of three types, mainly we have inclusion body, it's a low yield inclusion body myositis. Only remember, they will affect your distal muscles are inflamed. Other one is polymyositis. Here only muscle inflamed. Along with which muscles are inflamed here? Proximal muscles only inflamed, right? And it is mainly seen in old people. The most important one here, that is our dermatomyositis. You can see here skin is inflamed as well as muscle is inflamed. Here also which muscle? Proximal muscle will be inflamed. It is mainly seen in females, you can see both females and males, but females is predominantly affected. You can see a Schall sign, short sign. Then a Guttron papules in the finger, papules or heliotrope rash. If you see these things, sure you can confirm the patient have dermatomyositis. So they are proximal muscle in climbing stairs, difficulty brushing, like holding the things. This all will be difficult in them. Imagine. So both poly and derma, like they have around common feature, because it will be old people, young. Proximal muscles are inflamed. Here, remember, no skin is involved. For diagnosing, you can see increase in creatine kinase, increase in aldolase enzyme, and if you do that, you can do an EMG, electromyography. This all will be positive. But if someone asks you the best one always will be what? Biopsy. The best one, if you get all the option to treat, you give steroids, for sure it is autoimmune. These all are autoimmune disorder coming in rheumatology section. Sjogren syndrome and myositis, that is dermato and poly, are most important. Thank you.